Hello friends, and welcome again to another tutorial of Word 2016. And in this video we are going to talk about another Microsoft Word drawing tool, and that is edit points or edit shape points, and how to use connectors, which you can find in format menu after selecting a shape. Using edit points, you can quickly and easily make certain changes into predefined shapes or shapes that you have created using the freeform shape tool. So let's first draw any shape from Insert Shape drop-down menu, and from the Format menu, click Edit Shape drop-down menu, and then click Edit Points. As you can click the Edit Points option, you can immediately notice that all 6 white circle shape connectors will change into 4 dark black square connector, and you are now ready to edit shape. The default behavior while using edit point is corner points, and that is why you are seeing 4 black square on each side of the rectangle. I mean, let's say that if I draw a triangle and then use the edit points command, then you will see 3 black squares on each side of this triangle. So how many edit points will appear depends on the shape and corners in the shape, or you can say the connecting points in a shape. So now you can hold any of the point and can drag it in the desired position. As you will drag and drop a point, you can immediately notice that 2 white circles are now also appearing along with that point. You can use these white circle points to give a curve to that particular corner. If you would like, then you can also easily add a new point at any given position by just dragging and dropping. To remove an extra point, you can right click on that point and choose Delete Point from the context menu. You can also add a new point by right clicking on a particular position and then choose Add Point from the context menu. Edit points are very useful when using freeform from the Insert Shapes drop-down menu. You can draw rough sketch first using freeform, and can later modify the points to give it a more consistent look. Another interesting feature that you might find useful while using edit points is changing the point style. As I said earlier that the default style is corner points, but if you would like, then you can also change a particular point into a straight or smooth style by right clicking on that particular point. To give a shape a new look, you can also use open and close path commands. For instance, let's say that I draw a rectangle here and I want to change the rectangle into a callout. So what I can do is, I can right click on one of the corners and can then click on open path. Now I can drag that point to a new location and later choose close path from the context menu. Open and close path is also useful when working with freeform. Suppose while drawing a shape using freeform, by mistake I forget to make an intersection of the last points to completely close our shape. Then instead of drawing the entire shape again, you can right click on the last point and choose close path from the context menu to adjoin the last point with the closest point. So this was all about editing shape using edit points, and before ending this lesson, let me tell you about another interesting drawing feature called connectors. Connectors are used to draw a line between two shapes and connect both shapes together. If you open the Insert Shape drop-down menu and hover your mouse over the shapes available under Lines, you will find certain types of connector here. Keep in mind that it is easy to connect two shapes using connectors in Microsoft Excel and PowerPoint, and are very useful when you need to draw a flowchart manually. Choose any kind of connectors within from the lines and then move your mouse over a shape, and you will see blue dots will start appearing. Click over one of the blue dots from where you want to start the connection, and then draw a line over the second shape and connect with one of blue dots of the second shape. Now if you will move one of the shape, then connectors will move accordingly. However, if you move a shape after a connection, then the connected line will move accordingly. But if you have placed any of the shape in a completely different direction, then you can open the Edit Shapes drop-down menu and can click Reroute Connectors. This way, you don't have to delete and redraw a connector. But if you try to accomplish the same task in Microsoft Word, then to your surprise, no blue dots will appear when you will try to draw a connector over the first shape. This is because connectors do not behave in the same manner as they do in Excel and PowerPoint. To use connectors in Microsoft Word, you have to insert a new drawing column first, and then draw shapes within the columns. Now you can easily connect two shapes together using any of line connectors. So this was all about using edit points and connectors. If you find this video useful, then don't forget to hit that thumbs up button and do leave a comment. Thanks for watching, goodbye and take care.